Hello everybody, Camelia here from Calcedonia Sewing Channel. This is going to be a short video on demonstrating the binding of the keyhole and the neckline, binding of the neckline for the tailored dress from Designer Stitch. There are a few requests for that. Although it's a very easy steps in making this dress, but might be confusing, and you know, it's only a question of giving a little bit attention to on how you stretch the binding around the keyhole, and also of course keeping the seam allowance even all the way around. You'll see what I mean. So for bind your keyhole, in the instructions you have to do that before you put everything together. Here I have the dress almost done, because I used this I used it as a test garment. And I made it without a hole here in the center, and for this purpose I cut the hole out to demonstrate you how this is getting binded. So for this you need to have your neck binding. Cut it of course with the greatest stretch in the length, because you have to stretch this around your keyhole. And the next step is to mark the center front of your binding piece, and you can do that very easy by folding it in half. And also, you see in the instructions that you need to measure 3 inches and a quarter from the center front on both sides, from this middle point of the binding. So 3 1/4 here, 3 1/4 here, from the center front. Then the next step, you should have by now the center front here in the keyhole marked, and then you'll match right sides together the binding on the garment. And to do that, you start of course in the middle here, middle of the binding, pin it at the center of your garment. Very easy. And then the next very important thing is to match this mark, or I have a pin here, this mark of the binding, to match it here. So this is the garment, to match it here at the top of the keyhole. And then you'll do the same on the other side. I hope you can see it. I chose this also because the right side is very different than the front side of the wrong side of the fabric. The wrong side on both is white, and you have the print on the right side of the fabric. So you'll match here this pin that is 3 1/4 inches from the middle of the binding. You'll match it here at this point of the keyhole, at the lower point, because this point is a point from the neckline. So you'll match it of course as on the other side. You'll match these two points, put a pin, and as you'll see, the binding is much shorter than the garment part. As you can see here, you have very big difference, but because because the binding is cut on the greatest stretch, you will see that it will stretch enough to meet your garment. And the idea is, we are going to go to the machine now and sew all around. So you need to match these two pieces by stretching it. You stretch the binding and not the garment. You'll stretch it, and you'll sew very carefully with a 6 mm seam allowance. I'm going to change the cam to the sewing machine and then you'll see. And this seam allowance is very important to be even, because later you'll turn the binding to the inside, and of course you need to have an even edge, then an even seam allowance to get an even edge on your keyhole. Okay, so now we are at the machine and we are going to sew the binding to the keyhole, the first step. And as I said, it's very important to have a 1/4 inch seam allowance around the keyhole, and for that I'm using either a 1/4 inch quilter's foot, presser foot, or if I'm using my standard foot for my sewing machine, I'm always moving the needle to the right to have in a way that I have exactly 6 mm from this edge of the foot, so that I can very easily align my work with this edge of my foot, so I don't need to watch other lights or something like that. And for let me see, I can use the standard foot, maybe because maybe you don't have a quarter inch foot. I'm going to use the standard foot and I'm going to move the needle. And of course, if you cannot move your needle to on your machine, you can let the needle where it is and then try to find another point on your presser foot that you can use to be sure that you have that constant 6 millimeter seam allowance. So I have it now, I have now the standard foot on my machine and I'm going to move the needle to the right. And if I am not wrong, should be somewhere here. And I can measure that with my measuring tool. Let me see. And this is exactly 6 millimeters from the needle to this edge of my foot. So I'm going to sew this. I'm using a darker thread, dark blue. You should use something that is matching your fabric. And I'm sewing with the binding up, so with the garment to, on the presser foot, on the dog feet, sorry. We take the pin out, and I hope I have my cam in a good position that you can see what I'm doing. And the idea is that I think you can take a few stitches, and then there is no need to backstitch there because everything is going to get enclosed in the neck binding. And the idea is to help the binding a little bit to get around the keyhole, and in the same time you need to stretch and stretch only the binding and not the garment, and then you can sew. You don't need to hurry on this step because it's important to be accurate to have that 6 millimeters seam allowance. As you can see, if you go really easy, you can shape the binding very nice around the keyhole. And you can see here it's curling a little bit because the binding is you know, it's pulling everything together. So everything is getting sewn. We are at the center, take the pin out and then continue around. And I think the most important thing that you need to do in this step is to stretch your binding and to be sure that you are at the same on your 6 millimeters seam allowance point that you've chosen in the beginning. Maybe you need to adjust your work a little bit, it's okay. And you know, if you are like 1 millimeter away, you can fix that by trimming away, or you need to, you can come again to fix it. But do your best, and then of course you'll be faster ready with your tailor dress. Now we are almost at the end. You need to keep everything in place. And now we have the binding done. This is how it's looking. It's looking a little bit messy at this point. As you can see, everything is really stretched and gathered and things like that. This is from the inside. You can see here very clearly with the darker thread. There are no puckers because the seam allowance is only 6 millimeters. It's really actually it's really easy to sew in a round like this because or in a curved line like this, because it's much easier if you should have a very wide seam allowance. And actually a 6 millimeter seam allowance is working really great around necklines, especially when you need to bind them, because it's very easy to work with. The next step is to give this a good press. And the next step is going to be, so this is the binding, this is the garment, to we sew it like this, right sides together, and now we need to take the binding, wrap it over the seam allowance to the inside, and then you have your keyhole. And the next step, you can choose either stitch in the ditch or top stitch, depending on the fabric. On one of my tailor dresses I chose for the one that has a little bit, a bit of a pique structure I chose to top stitch it, and on this one with the crepe I stitch it in the ditch because that worked better for the fabric. I'm going to put again my pressing table here, and there you can see how it's looking pressed. As I said, the binding of the keyhole is done in the instructions before you have all the dress complete, and this is of course much easier than now, because you can put, if you should have here only the front panel, you could press this very easily. But now I need to put my pressing hem in the garment to have a good surface to press this. So the next step is to press it, and of course you will press the binding over the seam allowance, depending on your fabric it could press more difficult or even easier than here, but this is a scuba, it's not pressing very well, but with a little bit of help you should get there. I'm going to turn this that you can see how it's looking from the inside. This is the inside at this moment, as you can see it like this, and the idea is to get the binding, as I said, over the edge, and then you get this pretty neat finish of your keyhole. Don't stretch it too much, don't pull too much over the seam allowance that you're getting, you know, that is getting everything folded, and you know, you'll feel with your fingers when you push this over the edge that everything is still flat here in the inside. Of course it's very useful, you know, if the fabric is pressing nice, you can even give it a little bit of press again. Otherwise, with this scuba, I'm just pinning it and working my way around the keyhole. As you can see, starting to look like a binding already. I'm going to show you in a moment how it's looking from the inside. I'm not going to film anymore how I'm stitching this in the ditch, because I think this is not important. So it's either stitching in the ditch, either top stitching, and I think you should choose something that you also intend to use for the neckline, because then you are, you know, you have the same method. I think it's looking nice if it's constant. So this is how it's looking now. Very important is after you are going to stitch everything together, so even either top stitching or stitch in the ditch, it's very important to give it a good press, and then you see how nice this is sitting, very flat and very nice. I'm going to meet you in a few seconds after I'm sewing everything together. Okay, so my binding is top stitched. I chose to do that because it's faster, and because of this, this is not a real garment that I'll wear, you know, outside. So I did my best with the top stitching. Not really my best, as you can see. But, you know, if you choose a color that is matching your fabric, it's not going to be very obvious if you make a mistake. The next important thing is to give this a good press, because when you are top stitching it or stitching in the ditch, of course you have to do a bit of stretching again to make it right, straight, that you can sew it in a nice even way. So at this moment the neck binding is done. I'm going to show you also the inside, maybe you want to see that. As you can see, it's really difficult if the garment is completely done. As you can see here, I get a little bit of curling, but if I'm going to clip this everything away, then you see only the previous stitching line, but that is okay. And of course, if you would stitch it in the ditch, then you cannot see the previous stitching line. This is how it's going to look at the end. Okay, for the neckline, of course, you have the neck binding, and is this a long piece you find in your pattern? And also here is very important that you cut with a greater stretch in the length. And this is the neck binding. You have to sew it together with on the shorter ends with a 6 mm seam allowance here. And then you have to attach it on your neckline as per instructions. So you need to quarter it. You need to find your middle, your the half, and then you'll meet the seam, the shorter edges that they are sewn together, so that seam with the middle, and then you have the other two quarters, and then you have to do the same with your neck with your neckline. First you have to put this to wrap them that they are going to stay close. And my advice is to wrap them like this. So you need to wrap them right over left as per instructions. And I must say that I had a little bit of a trouble with this. But at the moment, for the moment, you need to wrap them, let them like that. And when you are coming with your neck binding, try to see, I'm going to show you, that you need to see that they are not wrapping too much, that you get a big gap here on your keyhole. But I'm going to sew this together. I'm going to quarter my neckline and my binding, and I'm going to meet you again here to attach it to the neckline. Okay, so I have I'm now at the point to attach the binding to the neckline. I quartered the binding and the neckline, and as you see, the quarters on the neckline, so are the center back, the center front, and not the shoulders, but you see that you are coming a little bit to the front with your marks. So I matched 3 points, and now I'm at the point to match the neckline, the keyhole. I'm just matching these two ones, and I'm going to put a pin at around 6 mm, like I will have the seam allowance. And then you need to take a peek to see if this under, if you are going to sew those 6 mm, if everything is going to look neat. And as you can see here, my right neck binding is coming a little bit too much here to the side. Let me show you better. So this is a point where you need to fiddle a little bit around. Let's see here. And I don't want that. I want to have my binding somewhere here, that everything is getting really nice and really tight there. So I'm just going to move the binding 1 mm lower. It's a little bit difficult to do this from the side. Let's see. And I think I'm much happier with this one now. And this is going to be sewn, so right sides together, again with a 6 mm seam allowance, everything, and then turned and over and top stitched like we did on the keyhole. And then you have a very nice binded neckline. Also here very important to stretch, as you can see here also the garment is a little bit longer, to stretch the binding, as you can see. But it's not so the difference is not so big as at the keyhole, so you need to stretch the binding a little bit to match your neckline. Also here the seam allowance is 6 mm. I hope this video did help a little bit with how this is done. If you have any questions, put them in the comments and I'll do my best to answer them. As I said, for the binding, for the neckline, the only important thing is to take a peek here before you start to stitch if your binding is going to finish where you want, and if this is looking very nice. And because if you are going to overlap too much and then you are going to put your binding on, you will see that you get here a very big you get a gap here, and this is not looking very nice. So the idea is to overlap those two pieces just enough to get them closed, and when you put that 6 millimeters, to have it nice and close. Okay, that was everything. If you have questions, please ask them and I'll do my best to help you. Thank you so much for watching and good luck with your tailor. Bye!